What is up, guys? Karma Medic here, and welcome back to another dose. If you're new to the channel, then hi, my name is Nasir, and I'm now a fourth year medical student studying at King's College London. As you can see from my surroundings, I'm not in my usual room back in London where you normally see me film my videos. I'm currently on peripheral placement for my obstetrics and gynecology rotation somewhere outside of London, and honestly, obs and gynae has just been fantastic. So we've got a pretty busy day today. I've got afternoon clinic in the genito-urinary medicine slash contraception clinic. I've got a meeting with my clinical supervisor, and our biggest med school exams are coming up pretty soon. So this is my exam studying timetable, and today we're over here, so we're going to be studying neuro, which is good because I could use a bit of neuro studying. It's currently 8 in the morning, so without further ado, let's get dressed, pack my bag, and head to the library. Best thing about this peripheral placement is that my commute to the hospital, my commute to the library, takes me a whole 2 minutes. It's literally the best thing ever. After a solid studying session of reading and taking notes, I move on to doing practice questions, which is really important for committing your knowledge to memory. And for this, we got to give a shout out to the sponsor of today's video, Quesmed. Quesmed is an online question bank for medical students with over 6,500 questions and 15,000 Anki style flashcards. If that wasn't enough, there's an entire textbook of notes so you can read up on the latest information for every single condition. One of my favorite things about Quesmed is that you can go through their questions using the app on your phone, even if you're offline, which is amazing for me when I'm commuting on the London Underground. Another feature is that you can actually search for questions relating to just the specific condition that you want to test your knowledge on. Compared to other question banks I've used, Quesmed definitely gets me thinking harder about their cases and makes me really consider multiple differentials as opposed to just seeing a buzzword and jumping straight to the answer. They've got great explanations for why each of their answers is right or wrong, and a comment section so you can discuss questions and topics with other users. Their spaced repetition flashcards auto-populate as you get questions wrong, so you don't even have to spend the time making the flashcards in the first place. Quesmed does it automatically for you. They're an absolutely fantastic resource for anyone in medical school, and the first 100 people to use my code KARMAMEDIC25 will get 25% off any plan, and after that you can use the code KARMAMEDIC for 10% off. Thank you to Quesmed for sponsoring this video, and let's get back to the vlog. Alright guys, healthy session of morning studying done. Now it's time for my clinical supervisor meeting. So this is the mid-placement clinical supervisor meeting. So each rotation that we do, we have a beginning of the placement, mid-placement, and then end of placement clinical supervisor meeting. So what we do in these meetings is we discuss our progress throughout the placement. And yeah, it's kind of like a check-in, just how have you been finding the placement? Is there anything I can help you with? Are you having any problems? Things like that. So I need to set up a quick Zoom call. I'll be honest, throughout my time in medical school, I haven't really found these meetings very useful. They've mostly been tick box exercises because my clinical supervisors haven't really been invested in, you know, the student experience and making sure that they're okay. However, my clinical supervisor during this rotation on obs and gynae has been excellent, very, very keen on making sure that I'm learning, making sure that I'm active in placement, doing everything that I need to do. And I'm honestly really thankful for that. You know, that is part of what medical school is. It's you being taught and mentored by people who have done this before you and them sort of taking you under their wing. And so I really appreciate that. It's been a good experience, this blog. Okay, anyways, I'm rambling way too much and I need to send this link. Good morning, I'm fine, thank you, how are you? All right. All done. That was a great conversation. I feel like we got everything that we needed to do finished. And that is another thing ticked off the to-do list for today. So, it is currently 11:10.
All right, guys. So, I've got just a little bit of time before my shuttle bus comes to take me from this hospital to the next hospital, which is where I have my afternoon clinic in genitourinary medicine and contraception. I definitely hear a bunny rabbit behind me in these bushes. I'll try and film one for you if I catch it, but there's bunnies absolutely everywhere here. I don't see him, he's hiding. But anyways, if you didn't already know, that I am now officially on TikTok. You can see that right over here. I'm having so much fun posting on TikTok, and I'm posting there daily, actually.
These are the two books that I use to study for the grueling USMLE Step 1 exam.
Over the next couple of weeks, I'm going to be taking a little bit of a step back from YouTube and my other social media because it's getting a little bit much with my exams coming up, but I will be posting every single day on TikTok. I've got 8 videos stashed ready to go, and I'm doing one per day, so make sure you follow me.
I can definitely hear this bunny.
If I haven't filmed a bunny rabbit for you by the end of this vlog, then I've failed, and you can let me know in the comments down below. All right, bus is coming very soon, and I do not want to miss it, so let's get going. Alright homies, so I'm here a little bit early because of the shuttle bus schedule. So I'm gonna see if I can find somewhere to heat up my lunch. Let's go.
Lunch is finished. Time for the clinic. Let's go.
Guys, I told you I would find a bunny. I think I spotted one. There it is. Yes. I knew I wouldn't let you guys down. A bunny in the flesh. Let's see if we can go say hi. You guys think it'll let me touch it? Probably not, let's be real. But you don't want to say hi? Hey, buddy. Oh my god, his eyes are so cute. I won't bother him anymore. But at least I found one for you guys.
All right. Finally, back home. I feel exhausted. So, clinic is finished. All the staff there were really, really nice, very welcoming. But from a learning perspective, from a seeing patient's perspective, it was pretty meh. Didn't get to see too much the insertion of a coil. Coil. As if everyone knows what a coil is. The coil that goes into the uterus and provides contraception long-term for women. And then also some presentations of sexually transmitted diseases like candidiasis, Nasir gonorrhea, but only underneath a microscope slide. So yeah, it was okay. It is what it is. Clinical placement really is like that. Sometimes it's completely slow and boring and nothing happens, and other times it's absolutely incredible and you're assisting in C-sections and seeing all this crazy stuff, so you get a bit of both worlds. The very first thing I'm gonna do is change into comfy clothes and just chill out for a little bit because I'm heading to the library with Georgina in an hour. So I can take a little bit of a break and then go continue for second half of the day. All right, guys. After talking to Alexia and a very healthy session on TikTok, my alarm has rang. And it's time to get up. So let's go make some snacks and some coffee for the library and then meet with Georgina and get going. All right, we're here with Georgina.
Hi, YouTube.
As you guys will know from previous vlogs, Georgina has been my companion in the library over the last couple of weeks. We got our snacks together.
Woohoo!
We studied together and it's been a good time.
It's been really useful, yeah.
It's been really useful. But guys, basically, we've been studying for how many weeks now?
It feels like forever, but...
It feels like forever.
Maybe 3 or 4 actual hardcore weeks.
And we've got another 3 weeks ahead of us. So it's the 29th today. Our exam is on the...
the 20th.
So it's coming up real soon. And we were saying this yesterday in the library, like, we're so done. Like, I've had enough.
Yeah, I absolutely feel the same. I think we've both had those points where we've been like, I'm done, and we've said to each other, I don't know what I'm doing anymore, am I doing this right? And I think it's perfectly natural, really.
Yeah, it must be. This is our fourth year in uni. We've written more exams than we care to count. We've also both done degrees prior to this, so like we've done this all before. And yeah, it's getting to the point where I've had enough. I just want to graduate, I want to start working.
Absolutely.
I want to have different responsibilities outside of uni.
Feeling recently like, just get me out of here, I want to start working.
Just
I feel ready.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know, just the end will come. It sometimes feels like it's going to be forever when you're in this state.
Very true.
And I know that a lot of people on our course are feeling the same at the moment. They're just like,
that's
when you
true.
See them in the street or in the hospital,
that is really
they're like
reassuring. Everyone feels
struggling.
The same way.
Yeah. Struggle Central.
Struggle Central.
Struggle City. Population 450.
What's our plan for tonight?
We've got a tutorial at 6.
Oh no, boo.
No, you've got it too.
Oh, Tim Lancaster.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, fine, yeah.
I'm not sure what I'm going to cover.
I'm doing neuro.
Do you focus on specific topics?
Like one topic per day. And I find that that's helping, because before I was just doing scattergun, shotgun approach of like a bit of everything, and I was getting stressed out. Studying is our plan.
Studying is the plan.
All right, let's do it. I've got infinite snacks, so we'll be energized for a while.
We can do this.
All right, let's do it. See you in the library. Guys, I found another one. What would you call him? Jasper?
Bunnykins.
Bunnykins. Do you think he'll let us touch him?
Oh my goodness.
Oh my God. Run, rabbit, run. So that is all the studying that I'm doing for today. I think tomorrow marks our 3-week point until the exam. So from here on out, it's pretty much just gonna be go, 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 study, study, study. So it's currently 9:15 p.m. Usually at this time, I would go straight into working out using the weights that I have here. Let me show you guys. I've got my yoga mat over there, which I lay out over here. And then I've got some weights, which have been very, very nice on this peripheral placement. Now I'm actually going on a planned 10 to 15K run with a friend tomorrow in Hyde Park back in London. So I'm gonna conserve my energy and not do exercise today. But I do have footage of me exercising from another day, so roll that clip. So before I came to Ashford, my good friend Georgina.
Hi YouTube.
She told me that everyone gets fat in Ashford. And let's just say I haven't exactly got the healthiest of snacks sitting on my shelf. So I promised myself I'm not gonna get fat. And I've been working out almost every other day that I've been here. Haven't got anything too crazy, just this mat, a couple of weights, and some extra plates over there. It's definitely keeping me in shape and doing a good job in addition to running. So I'm gonna set you guys down and continue. Quick workout, all done. Let's continue on with the day. So on days where I'm not exercising, if my flatmates over here are free, then we meet up in one of our rooms and we go through past paper questions to help prepare for the upcoming exam. I've actually got some footage of that from the other day, so roll the clip. After one of those two things, I will have dinner, shower, and go straight to sleep. And that, my friends, is gonna bring us to the very end of this vlog. I really hope you've enjoyed watching. It's actually been quite fun filming this throughout the whole day, and very different filming on peripheral placement in my not at home in London environment, as I'm sure you've been able to tell. If you've enjoyed the video, please do leave a like on it and also subscribe to my channel to see more content from me in the future. Don't forget to follow me on TikTok as well. I'm posting daily there and having a blast, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace. That's it for me. I'm gonna go straight to bed because I've got a 7 a.m. wake up tomorrow morning, which is fantastic. So I'll see you tomorrow. You get the best of, not the best, you get a bit of both worlds. Shout out Miley Cyrus.
I do.
You smashed it.
Yes.
That was so fantastic.
Yes, yes, yes.
So while I'm here on peripheral placement, and we go through a bunch of...
If you've enjoyed the video, please don't leave a like.